It's a sad day for democracy and journalism in New Zealand. That's just some of the reaction to today's announcement that Newshub, one of the biggest newsrooms in the country, is set to shut down. Warner Brothers Discovery, the American owner of TV3, is proposing to close the news division at the end of June. The move's rocked the media sector, with about 300 jobs expected to go. Kim Baker-Wilson joins us shortly from 3's headquarters. His report first.
Staff just told more than three decades of journalism is set to stop in a matter of months.
Thinking of all of our colleagues at the moment.
Colleagues in the field were told to drop their stories and get back to the office. At its Auckland headquarters, it was two security guards and company-wide meetings.
Just shock, really.
Their jobs set to go in June.
We've looked at, you know, many, many options on, you know, how the newsroom could potentially transform. The reality of it is the scale of the downturn in the TV advertising market has been so great, we haven't seen a viable option other than what we've announced today.
Newshub's owners are a multi-billion dollar international.
Good evening.
But they say for 3, the channel to survive, Newshub has to be axed.
I don't believe there's anything that the network could have done substantially. No, there was no other way this is going to go. And television, free-to-air television, isn't as profitable as it used to be.
3's last finances show it losing tens of millions of dollars in a year. It never asked the government for help.
And they did say things were not going too well. They didn't ask for any assistance in terms of funding.
Warner Brothers Discovery has never actually reached out for assistance. It's not something that they felt that was helpful.
And it's unlikely there'll be any now.
Well, it's up to each individual corporation, as it is in every other sector in our economy.
Hundreds could lose their jobs, faces that have been here for years, and those just starting out.
You aspire to be like those people, you know, and then you saw yourself at 3 and to know that there's probably potentially not a future there, so.
It's an amazing team and everyone's just been working really hard over the last couple of months, and I think we'll just continue to do the same.
Tonight, that team's reporting on themselves. Jobs on the line more than ever, and a deadline they don't want getting closer.
Kim, your story touched on the ad revenue situation. Just how bad is it?
Well, it's well known that it is tough times across the entire media sector at the moment. There have been many redundancies, more are likely to come. And staff were told in those meetings today that $100 million has been swiped from advertising in this country. That is money that free-to-air broadcasting depends on. One of the reasons, the cost of living. People are spending less. It means that people, companies, are advertising less. Warner Brothers Discovery says that there's no single event that has led it to this point today. Lots of things have come together at the same time, and that every time it thought it got a handle on things, some new issues would crop up again. But axing an entire news division with a lot of history behind it, that is a major move. The broadcasting minister was told last night, the prime minister this morning, and staff at those meetings later this morning. A lot of the staff coming out had very brave faces on. A lot of them were in tears, but one thing we did hear over and over again is that this is a family here and that they will continue to make the news for as long as they can.
Tēnā koe, Kim. Thank you very much. Well, from its launch in 1989, 3 National News, later becoming Newshub, was part of the country's first private television channel. But as Simon Mercep explains, it encountered financial challenges right from the get-go.
First came the promo.
Now he's back.
Good evening, I'm Philip Sherry.
Then on the 27th of November 1989, television journalism here changed.
Good evening, an Auckland man is in prison tonight.
Somebody's taken this baby over and it's going to run. It's a wonderful feeling.
3 National News became the privately owned rival to One Network News.
That was one of the main driving forces that, you know, they saw themselves in competition with TVNZ.
That competition was fierce from the get-go.
I personally think one of us is going to struggle. I hope it's you, you hope it's me.
As it turned out, the one to struggle early was TV3.
It has been very, very rough. You know, it launched 35 years ago. Almost immediately ran into problems.
The channel went into receivership 5 months after its launch. Over the years, it had several owners, ending up with Discovery in 2020. And when it merged with Warner Brothers, three was in the hands of a global media giant.
The one thing that's helped it recover and get by is the fact it's had really good staff, really hard-working staff.
Some of those staff became well-known faces.
Hello. Well, it's been a bit of a miserable Monday.
So we come on three news, the flu vaccine shortage.
Kia ora, good evening. The Supreme Court has...
Kia ora, good evening. Police have made an arrest in the cold case.
We are here to debate the future of our country.
One commentator says it's a grim day that strikes at our democracy.
I couldn't now, hand on heart, say get into journalism because it's a career with a great future. And that saddens my heart.
That sadness will be keenly felt tonight across the media industry.
You've been in the media game for 40 years, Simon. In terms of journalism in New Zealand, how big a hit is this?
It is a big hit, Simon, not just because a major player is lost, but in a small industry where many people know each other well. This is an emotional hit too. Many journalists have worked for both organisations. We rub shoulders out in the field. Many of our careers will have been shaped by having a competitor. I only got a job here at TVNZ in late 89 because some folks had left here to go and set up TV3. So today in our newsroom, there was genuine concern for our counterparts at Newshub. And also it reinforced the feeling that this is a tough time for the media business, and who knows, others may come on hard times too. And just on this issue of competition, it was always important. In those early days, we would gather around the TV sets at 6 o'clock, watch those bulletins go out in the newsroom. If your editor thought that three had done a better job, to use the technical term, you'd get a bollocking. It's not quite like that now, but that competition has always been something to keep us on our toes and to produce our best journalism. So make no mistake, today is a loss.
Absolutely. Simon, thank you very much for that.